Is it safe?
My name is Eleanor Frederick. I'm the Family and Consumer Science Agent here at Cooperative Extension in Alamance County, and this is Horrors of the Kitchen. Last time, we talked about how to prevent foodborne illness through cleaning. For food that is prepared and ready to eat, it's really important to keep potentially contaminated food, like raw meat, away. In this segment, we'll be talking about keeping food separate and how that's an important part of food safety. I have some chicken that I'm cutting to prep to put on top of a salad that I'm making. Even though I've washed this knife, this cutting board, and my hands, I could still make someone sick if I cut this lettuce and make it into a salad. Cross-contamination occurs when potentially contaminated foods, like this raw chicken, come into contact with items that are ready to be eaten, like this washed lettuce. The foods don't even have to be directly touching to spread contamination. Wiping or rinsing an item between uses doesn't cut it, which is one of the reasons why cleaning and sanitizing are important steps. The easiest thing to do is to use separate surfaces and utensils. Have one for high-risk foods like raw chicken and another for ready-to-eat foods like washed produce. If you find color organization helpful, most stores carry color-coded cutting boards and knives to assist in keeping food separated during preparation. Separating potentially contaminated foods from ready-to-eat foods starts before the food prep. At the grocery store, keep produce and other loosely packaged items away from raw meat in your shopping cart. The packaging on raw meat in the grocery store doesn't necessarily stop contamination. Food safety researchers have found high numbers of microbes on the outside of food packaging in the meat sections of grocery stores. So make sure that when you're in the grocery store, you use the plastic bags offered to you at the meat counter. When you get home from the store, load your fridge with food safety in mind. Store raw meat below produce and ready-to-eat items to prevent cross-contamination from dripping meat juice. Contain those raw items to help stop dripping in the first place. At the store, in the fridge, and during food prep, remember to keep risky items separate from foods that are ready to be eaten. Keeping those foods separate is a major part of preventing foodborne illness. So how do you lower the risk of foods like raw meat? Well, you cook it. We'll talk about that next time.